Hello children, welcome to science class of grade 3. The last class we have learned about a kind of simple machine, levers, from block 15, machines in daily life. Now today let us classify it. Based on the three parts, we are going to classify the levers. So we have learned that a lever is having three parts. So what are they? Effort, load and fulcrum. So we have learned that a lever is having three parts, effort, load and fulcrum, which is a fixed point to a lever. So based on that, when the fulcrum we see in the center, when the fixed point is at the center, we say that these kinds of levers are class 1 levers. So when the fixed point fulcrum, when we see for a simple machine lever, that fixed point when it is at the center, we call that it is a class 1 lever. So examples, we can see scissors and seesaw. So in the scissor, we can see at the center point the fixed point is, and even seesaw, you can see the fixed point is at the center. So these levers are the class 1 levers. And now in the class 2 levers, we can see fulcrum. Is the fixed point is at any one of the end. Then, and what is at the center? Load is in the center. So, when three parts arrangement differs, even the classification differs for the levers. So, when fulcrum is at one of the end, load will be in the center. So, for example, nutcracker and wheelbarrow, you can see nutcracker. You can see the load will be in the center and the fulcrum fixed point is at the one of the end. So, and the effort is at one of the end. So, these kind of levers are class 2 levers. So, class 2 levers examples, you can see nutcracker and wheelbarrow. You can see many other examples. I am giving two examples here. And class 3 levers. Coming to the class 3 levers, fulcrum is at the one of the end, that means fixed point is at one of the end, and what will be in the center? Effort will be in the center. Load is at one of the corner and the fulcrum is at one of the corner. So what will be in the center? Effort will be in the center. So when class 1 levers, fulcrum is in the center, and for class 2 you can see load is in the center, for class 3 effort will be in the middle of the lever. So fulcrum and load are at the both ends of a lever. So, this is a class 3 levers. This type of levers we call it as class 3 levers. Examples, you can see stapler. It is also fixed at one of the end, but the effort will be in the center. So, how it works? I will show you with the examples. So, even our arm is also an example for class 3 levers. How? It is fixed at one of the end and you can see effort is in the center and load you can hold. So, where is the effort when you are carrying something? Effort is in the center and the fulcrum which is fixed at one of the point and load you will carry with your one of the end. So, this is also an example for class 3. So, based on the arrangement of the fulcrum, we have classified into how many types? Three types, class 1, 2 and 3. So, these are the examples, children. Now, I will show with the examples. Children, look at three examples of levers. Class 1 lever, where fulcrum you can see in the center and the effort you will give at one corner and the load which you are going to cut is nothing but a load. You can cut at one end. So, fulcrum in the center, class 1 lever example. Now, you can see nutcracker, lemon squeezer is example of class 2 levers. Where you can see the fulcrum, you can see the fixed point at one corner and the load will be in the center and the effort you are giving here. Effort at one corner and the load will be in the center and fulcrum is at one of the end. And here, in class 3 lever examples, you can see fixed point is at one end and when you are going to staple book or any paper, then you can see this is at one end, the load it is at one end and the effort where you are putting here, effort is in the center. Now this is an example of class 3 levers, where fulcrum is in the center and where here load is in the center for class 2 levers and effort is in the center for class 3 levers. So these are the three examples of levers, children. Now open your readers. Children, open page number 96 in your reader. Here you can see pictures of levers, class 1 lever, first class lever, second class lever and third class lever. Here, classes of levers. There are three classes of levers. In each class, the fulcrum, load and the effort are arranged in different ways. In class 1 levers, the fulcrum is between the load and the effort. Examples are scissors, seesaw and balance scale. In class 2 levers, the load is between the effort and the fulcrum and the examples are wheelbarrow, bottle opener and nutcracker. And in class 3 levers, the effort is between the fulcrum and the load. Examples are fishing rods, human hand and a stapler. Now you are going to read the lesson, children, and you are going to draw these figures on your plain side of your classwork. And you are going to label each part. For first class lever and second class lever and third class lever, you are going to draw these figures on plain side of your classwork. Now see the practice questions. Now today you are going to complete 5th and 6th. Describe 3 classes of levers and give an example of each. So you are going to describe 3 classes of levers. So you are going to describe 3 classes of levers. You are going to write this answer and you are going to give an example. What kind of levers are the following? They have given examples here. You are going to identify which class levers it belongs to. So lemon squeezer is there, scissors is there and fishing rod is there. So which kinds of classes it belongs to? Lemon squeezer is a class 2 lever, second class lever, and scissors are class 1 levers and fishing rod is class 3 levers. So in this way you are going to identify and you are going to complete your classworks 5th and 6th answer. And you are going to draw the figures also. Now open your workbook, children. Open your workbook, page number 37, children. You are going to write today's day and you are going to complete S3, classes of levers. Label the parts of a lever and write the class of the lever. So when the fulcrum is at one point, one of the end, so you are going to give an effort in the center and load here. So, which class lever it is? When effort is in the center, class of lever given above is class 3 levers. Now, draw an example for 3 kinds of levers and label the fulcrum, effort and load in each one of them. So, you are going to draw any one of the examples of class 1 lever, class 2 lever and class 3 levers. So, there are so many examples. You can draw any one of them and you are going to label where is the load, where is the fulcrum and where is the effort in the examples of levers. So you are going to even draw, label the parts of levers. Now see the third one, observe the picture below and answer the question. Name the body part in the picture. So what is this body part? This is an arm. And which class of lever is it? It is of class 3, where fulcrum is fixed at one of the end. You can see effort in the middle. So when effort is in the center, we say that it is class 3 levers. Now we can easily identify that our arm is an example of class 3 lever. Label the effort, fulcrum and load in the picture. Even you have to label in the picture also. You have to identify which part of the body it is and which class of lever it is and you are going to label it is. Okay, children, hope you have understood. Complete your works.